You know, I don't want to eat flavorless foods, and I don't want to give up my favorites, and I don't want to starve myself. I don't want to measure things or count calories or anything of the sort, and I'm sure you don't either. Why? Because all of that is extremely stressful, and as if life isn't stressful enough all on its own, we've got that to deal with. And guess what? All that stress could actually be making you heavier. You know, we all react to stress differently, and since I began exercising, I tend to take out my frustrations in the gym. It just wasn't always that way, though. You know, I used to let pressures in my life affect me negatively. You know, a long day in the office, and then a trip to the pub after work, leading to a sore head in the morning, followed by cravings for stodgy foods that would slow me down yet again, causing this snowball effect that left me with the movement and motivation of a sloth. You know, not a nice feeling. You know, we've heard for years about stress affecting our hearts, but it affects more, so much more. You know, it affects nearly every part of our physical cells. You know, when we have very stressful lives, there are many physical symptoms. Joints ache, muscles feel weak, our hormones are out of whack, our immune systems are weakened, and these physical problems just add to the physiological pressure we're under. You know, and guess what? As if the plate of brownies you consumed the other night after losing that promotion to your idiot colleague wasn't enough, the physical way in which your body responded to all that stress you've been under might have added a few extra pounds as well. We produce the hormone cortisol when we're under stress, and the kicker is that cortisol can cause your body to produce more abdominal fat. Abdominal fat is the undesirable, aesthetically pleasing fat under your stomach, and it's the most dangerous type of body fat. You know, this is called visceral fat and has been linked to increased rates of cardiovascular disease and type 2 diabetes, as well as breast cancer in women. So, should you give up and let yourself go? I mean, after all, it's not as if we can stop stressful things from happening, right? What do we do? Well, first of all, stop putting yourself under lots of stress yourself. You know, maybe it's unadvisable to tell the boss what you really think about his or her latest idiotic idea, but you can reduce personal stress by choosing not to follow a ridiculously restrictive diet. Stop starving yourself or following plans that are clearly unhealthy. Stop denying yourself of foods that you love. Stop eating flavorless foods because you've been told you'll lose weight if you follow a particular meal plan. It makes me so angry that people are adding to their stressful lives because of their constant quest to be thin and perfect. It really doesn't need to be that way. I know you want to lose weight, but healthy weight loss does not have to be stressful. My clients are busy people who find that working out relieves stress from the daily grind. The last thing I want to do is add more stress to their lives. The lunchbox diet is convenient and versatile. People enjoy making and eating their own creations and coming up with new secret recipes. Colleagues, clients, and friends are always trying to get a peek in my box, and I love to share ideas, particularly like on the Facebook page, which is at www.facebook.com/lunchboxdiet. If you go and hit the like button, you'll get all my kind of boxes and stuff like that. So go and do that. If people didn't share, then we would never learn. With social media now, it's just a fantastic way to learn and share things. You know, here's another piece of advice: surround yourself with people who you aspire to be like, and you will end up being like them. You know, surround yourself with stressed people, and you'll end up being stressed yourself. And the same can be said for if you surround yourself with people who eat bad, junky foods. You know, have a think about who you are and how much of that is influenced by the people you surround yourself with. You may want to make a few changes in your life to help you on a more positive path, and this in turn will assist you with your weight loss. I found that my clients like losing weight without all of the stress of traditional dieting, and that's why I allow occasional indulgences while helping you to retrain your taste buds and enjoy healthy foods. You'll find that when you eat a diet full of healthy, nutritious food, you'll become more energetic, stronger, and healthier overall. And when you are less susceptible to illness and feeling your best, stress is much easier to handle. In addition, you'll discover there is no better stress buster than a good session in the gym or other energetic pursuits. And you don't have to exercise on the lunchbox diet, but you'll probably more be inclined to after a short amount of time because you'll just feel more healthier. Ultimately, my goal is help. to help you to lose weight, learn how to eat healthy for life, get you working out, and do it all without stress. You know, leave those fad starvation diets behind and let's delve into a little science. You know, we tend to beat ourselves up for being overweight. We feel as though it's about what we did or what we didn't do. You know, guess what? It's not all up to you. You weren't necessarily one who failed, and there's a better chance than zero that the diet failed you. There's reasons why diets fail us, and to understand this, you should need to know a basic nutritional principle. And don't worry, I'll make it fun. The first is a simple maths equation: weight maintenance and what goes in versus equals what goes out. You know, what goes in is obviously the food you consume measured in calories, which is a measurement term used for energy. Your energy intake must be equivalent to what your body burns in order to simply maintain your weight. What doesn't get burned is stored as fat. We burn energy every day and night to perform the basic necessities of life: breathing, digestion, brain function, and so forth. And the amount of energy burned for these basic functions varies according to the person's size, age, and sex. The larger the person, the harder the body has to work, so the more energy is burned. And as we get older, we burn less energy, which may be very well, you know, why some of you started this program in the first place. You know, for the first time in your life, you may be experiencing weight gain. You know, most of us do more during the day than simply breathing and digesting food, I hope. You know, how much more it varies depends on how physical people and their jobs. You know, others spend days sitting behind a desk, but we all have choices about what we can do with our free time. For some, relaxing means lying on the sofa, and for others, it means going out on a bracing hike. I know you want to lose weight, but healthy weight loss does not have to be stressful. My clients are busy people who find that working out relieves stress from the daily grind. The last thing I want to do is add more stress to their lives. The lunchbox diet is convenient and versatile. People enjoy making and eating their own creations and coming up with new secret recipes. Colleagues, clients and friends are always trying to get a peek in my box, and I love to share ideas, particularly on the Facebook page, which is at www.facebook.com/lunchboxdiet. If you go and hit the like button, you'll get all my kind of boxes and stuff like that, so go and do that. If people didn't share, then we would never learn. With social media now, it's just a fantastic way to learn and share things. You know, here's another piece of advice: surround yourself with people who you aspire to be like, and you will end up being like them. You know, surround yourself with stressed people, and you'll end up being stressed yourself. And the same can be said for if you surround yourself with people who eat bad, junky foods. You know, have a think about who you are and how much of that is influenced by the people you surround yourself with. You may want to make a few changes in your life to help you on a more positive path, and this in turn will assist you with your weight loss. I found that my clients like losing weight without all of the stress of traditional dieting, and that's why I allow occasional indulgences while helping you to retrain your taste buds and enjoy healthy foods. You'll find that when you eat a diet full of healthy, nutritious food, you'll become more energetic, stronger, and healthier overall. And when you are less susceptible to illness and feeling your best, stress is much easier to handle. In addition, you'll discover there is no better stress buster than a good session in the gym or other energetic pursuits. And you don't have to exercise on the lunchbox diet, but you'll probably more be inclined to after a short amount of time, because you'll just feel more healthier. Ultimately, my goal is to help you to lose weight, learn how to eat healthy for life, get you working out, and do it all without stress. You know, leave those fad starvation diets behind and let's delve into a little science. You know, we tend to beat ourselves up for being overweight. We feel as though it's about what we did or what we didn't do. You know, guess what? It's not all up to you. You weren't necessarily one who failed, and there's a better chance than zero that the diet failed you. There's reasons why diets fail us, and to understand this, you should need to know a basic nutritional principle. And don't worry, I'll make it fun. The first is a simple maths equation: weight maintenance and what goes in versus equals what goes out. You know, what goes in is obviously the food you consume measured in calories, which is a measurement term used for energy. Your energy intake must be equivalent to what your body burns in order to simply maintain your weight. What doesn't get burned is stored as fat. We burn energy every day and night to perform the basic necessities of life, breathing, digestion, brain function and so forth. And the amount of energy burned for these basic functions varies according to the person's size, age and sex. The larger the person, the harder the body has to work, so the more energy is burned. And as we get older, we burn less energy, which may be very well, you know, why some of you started this program in the first place. You know, for the first time in your life, you may be experiencing weight gain. You know, most of us do more during the day than simply breathing and digesting food, I hope. You know, how much more it varies depends on how physical people and their jobs. You know, others spend days sitting behind a desk, but we all have choices about what we can do with our free time. For some, relaxing means lying on the sofa, and for others, it means going out on a bracing hike. Now, I don't want you to count every calorie, nor become a slave to the calories burn function on your treadmill. However, you must adjust your eating to accommodate your activity level. It's just common sense. Now, energy intake can be seen as a budget. When you wake up, you get a basic allowance according to your energy needs for the day that you can spend without the price of weight gain. All day long, you spend this energy budget whenever you eat. If you take some form of exercise, you earn more energy, so your food budget is larger, and you can eat more without gaining weight than the others who are less active. And we'll talk more about food budget and food choices when we get into the lunchbox diet. For now, let's go back to our equation. Now, I'm assuming you care less about weight maintenance and a lot more about weight loss. So in looking at our equation, you can easily see that in order to lose weight, you need to do one of two things or both. A, reduce what goes in, so lower your energy intake. B, increase what goes out, so burn more energy. Or C, ideally combine the two, eat less and burn more energy. Okay, it seems simple, but for the most part, people find this hard. Now, I don't want to do a lot of counting, but for the sake of this, let's work it out. You know, 1 pound of body weight is more or less equivalent to 3,500 calories. And this is convenient considering there are 7 days in a week. So you can quickly see that if you reduce your energy intake by 500 calories a day or burn an additional 500 calories, so that's like a 40-minute jog, you should theoretically lose about a pound a week. Now, you might be tempted to adjust this even more severely to lose weight more quickly. The fact is, in order to lose weight effectively, or in other words, keep the weight off, slow and steady is the key. Now, there are guidelines to what people say is safe, but we need to remember that depending on your current weight and the changes to your diet and exercise, weight will drop off at different rates per individual. Usually, the heavier you are, the more initially you'll lose, and the weight comes down, as I said, a bit more quickly. And then as you drop weight, you'll be going into more of a steady weight loss and then a maintenance level. What we want to steer away from is ridiculous calorie chop, where you're taking a substantially low amount of calories per day. But don't worry, that's not going to happen here. You won't be able to continue a very low calorie diet forever, and once you resume eating more than carrot sticks and hot water, you'll simply get it back again. And it also mucks up your metabolism, which we'll discuss later. Fortunately, with the lunchbox diet, it's a sustainable plan that you can see working long term as part of your new happy lifestyle. So, why do diets fail? The majority of fad diets are nothing more than a very low calorie diet with a gimmick or smokescreen to cover up this fact. Whether you're told to eat grapefruit or drink a strange mixture, at the end of the day, you've consumed far fewer calories, often to the extreme. At best, there is a small grain of truth in each theory, but only to a minuscule degree. All that these diets do, once again, is cover up the fact that calories are being restricted no matter what horse or pony show went into making you not eat. And most of the time, you will not be able to stick with it because, quite simply, people get hungry. We like to eat. We don't usually enjoy hunger pangs, weakness and dizziness. We enjoy treats like chocolates and crisps. We can go some time without these things, but if you ignore a craving long enough, chances are it will come back to bite you in the bum, and a little craving for a taste of chocolate will snowball into eating the entire box. So let's recap. Healthy weight loss relies on one equation. fad diets fail because most are very low calorie diets, or VLCDs for short. Fad diets fail because they are too stringent, and fad diets fail because they are not built for the long run. Also, fad diets fail because starving yourself will mess with your metabolism. Metabolism? I know what you're thinking. You said I'll keep it simple, and I will. So, the bare necessities that we need to learn. Metabolism is the rate at which our bodies burn calories, or, in other words, fuel. The higher the metabolism, the faster the fuel is burned. The lower the metabolism, the lower the fuel is burned. When you starve yourself, you end up lowering your metabolism. The best way I can explain how metabolism aids in weight loss is to talk about bears. Yep, you heard me right. A bear spends all summer fattening itself up. It has to fatten up to get through the whole winter without eating. A bear's metabolism slows way down during hibernation. This is the body's way of preserving all that fat that the bear put on last summer. Good for the bear, not so good for you. When was the last time you saw a bear having to wear a backless cocktail dress? When we starve ourselves, we need to do the same thing to our metabolism, as hibernation does to the bear's metabolism. So, without any new fuel source, your body works as effectively as possible by lowering its metabolism to conserve any existing fuel. It stores what it can. Conversely, when you eat small amounts of food frequently throughout the day, or graze, rather than starve yourself, your metabolism remains at optimum fuel burning level. It can rely on getting fuel every 1 to 2 hours, and therefore it burns fuel instead of storing it. That being said, you can eat a high-calorie, high-fat food every 1 to 2 hours and still lose weight. So, what do you eat? Well, that's where this diet plan comes into play. In designing the diet, I knew that I wanted my clients to graze, but I didn't want them to give them a blanket instruction on how to eat all day. They needed to eat foods that they had that had a lot of nutritional punch per bite without having a lot of calories. They needed something lasting that would taste great without a ton of calories, and some foods are just fattening but low in nutrients, and those are the types of foods that when consumed regularly make us fat. So what about beyond the mirror? In a world where thin is in and obesity isn't, you know, it's tough to be heavy for a whole range of different reasons. Many of you involved in this program because you're tired of being heavy and have chosen to do something about it. Good on you. I've seen so many people literally change their entire lives when they drop the pounds. For most people, food means so much more than just fuel for our bodies. We use it at nearly every celebration, birthday cake, Easter eggs, and don't even get me started on the days of feasting around Christmas. We're taught at a very young age that sweets and cakes are pleasant things make us feel good. If you scrape a knee, you get a plaster followed by a lolly to turn off the tears. The lolly doesn't fix the wound, but distracts the child's attention from the pain. When you're sad, lonely, restless, anxious, or angry, your lolly might be chocolate cake or a fast food burger that distracts you from your emotions. For a brief moment, you're preoccupying yourself by doing something pleasurable. Unfortunately, it's not lasting, just like the lolly doesn't fix the wound. Food can't fix what's really wrong. What's worse is that the excess food is only complicating your life further. It's a vicious cycle. We eat too much because we're depressed. We gain weight, we get more depressed, we eat more, we gain more, and so on. It's time to stop the cycle. When you start treating your body right, when you take control of your weight instead of letting it take control of you, you will empower yourself to make changes in other areas of your life. You may not be able to fix everything overnight, but a journey begins with a single step. You have taken that step by getting involved in this program, and I won't let you down. I will be there on this journey. For starters, I want you to go to lunchboxdiet.co.uk, put in your name and email address, and I will send you regular motivational emails to keep you on the path. You know, I'm constantly coming up with new products, tips and tricks, and I'll share these with you. How about that for a bonus? You know, though looking good will be a big part of the end result of following this plan, what's most important is how you will perceive yourself from the inside out once you begin the lunchbox diet. Eating healthy means feeling good. More energy, less illness, less chance of developing diseases related to obesity, and you'll be able to enjoy your life. Whenever you're feeling down, remember this word, believe. Believe in this diet, believe in your efforts, believe in me, believing above all in you and your abilities. We're going to get there, I promise it.